And Asaduddin Owaisi is debating tonight with Sudhanshu Trivedi of the BJP, Gaurav Bhatia, who's the spokesperson of the Samajwadi Party. And of course, Asaduddin Owaisi is the chief and a member of parliament of the Lok Sabha of the All India Majlis-e-Ittihad al-Muslimin. Thank you very much, AIMIM. Asaduddin Owaisi, there was absolutely no need for you to make this comment. Your comments are completely and utterly unacceptable. You have essentially claimed that India is an Islamic nation by claiming that every child is born a Muslim and that his parents and society convert him to other faiths. You are basically claiming that India is essentially a Muslim nation. Why have you made such an outrageous comment? And by the way, after your initial comments, we are open to debate. Asaduddin Owaisi.
Arnab, let me make it very clear to all of you that this is an age-old Islamic belief. It does not limit to Indian Muslims. Any Muslim living any part of the world, this is part of my belief system.
Is that what you're saying? Please allow me to complete.
I am not saying that, and I will never work on that level to make India a theocratic religious state. This is part of my belief system, belief faith, and you have all the right to disagree with me. And in that speech, I have made so many other points. And if one has to disagree with it, it is completely
no,
fine.
Mr. Owaisi.
Am I throwing down my faith on someone's face that you will not get a ration card if you don't become Muslim? We will give you 5 lakhs, accept Islam. Am I saying that you are only a nationalist if you become a Muslim? Am I saying that by 2021, whole of India would become Muslim?
Well,
Mr. Owaisi, firstly,
you have undermined the constitution of this country. You have undermined the preamble of the constitution.
No, you are absolutely wrong.
Mr. Owaisi, may I please?
Absolutely wrong.
No, I am not.
No,
Mr. Owaisi, and let me prove. Let me prove you wrong. Let me prove you wrong.
You know,
Mr. Owaisi, let me prove you wrong.
My faith is a freedom of religion. It is a fundamental right. I am not trying to make India an Islamic state. Please get it right.
Mr. Owaisi, I am not talking about religious laws here, Mr. Owaisi. If people of this nation, if people in this country are born Muslim, that is what you are saying, you are essentially saying, and I don't understand why after having said it, you are now trying to backtrack. You first make the point, you are essentially saying that the...
I am reiterating, I'll continue to reiterate tomorrow and to the day I live.
Okay,
because
so...
that is part of my faith.
Yes, and...
And my faith, I am not shoving down anybody's faith.
Of course you are.
I believe in freedom of religion. I believe in the diversity
have you finished?
Of this country, which is its ethos, which is its strength.
Have you finished, Mr. Owaisi? Now my point is, please hear this. You know, you have made an outrageous comment. Because if people in this country are born Muslim, which are your words, not mine, these are your words, not mine, you are essentially saying that the identity of this nation is essentially Islamic, which it is not. Just like those in the Sangh Parivar, claim that the identity of all Indians is essentially Hindu. There is, in other words, no difference between you or the VHP. There is zero difference between you or the VHP.
There is a difference, please understand. When RSS talks about Hinduism, they say that only a Hindu is a nationalist. They say
I am not talking about nationalism. Don't
say,
get
no.
Now that you have been defeated on your
that.
Basic argument,
I am saying this is part of my faith, and I'll say it.
But
that does not mean that I am trying to convert
India
to Islamic state,
Mr. Owaisi. You can
Muslims,
try and practice your polarizing politics
you
elsewhere.
You are twisting
Mr. Owaisi
statement. This is part of my faith. This
yes.
is the
one second.
Counters to any Indian Muslim, but to every Muslim.
Watch it. Before you come in, Gaurav Bhatia, I want to tell Mr. Owaisi. that every child, Mr. Owaisi, is not born a Muslim. Every child is not born a Muslim. Just like every child is not born a Hindu. Every child is not born a Christian. Every child is not born a Jew. Every child is not born a Zoroastrian. You cannot cloak. Mr. Owaisi, you just cannot cloak the entire planet with the blanket of one faith.
I will stick to it.
You cannot cloak the planet with the blanket of one faith. You cannot undermine other faiths.
You can disagree with me, but I will continue to practice my faith.
You are not practicing your faith. You are practicing.
Mr. Owaisi, you are not practicing your faith.
And now others want to come in, and Sudhanshu Trivedi and Gaurav Bhatia must have a right to respond, but you are not practicing your faith. You have sought to undermine other faiths by claiming that Islam is the real home to all religions.
Instead of showing equal respect to all faiths, you have sought to undermine non-Islamic faiths.
Mr. Owaisi,
today has heard the sentiments of every citizen of this country. And why I'm saying this is because I think people following Islam today would not agree with what he has said. India is a nation where all religions live in harmony. And he is a member of parliament who should have allegiance to the constitution and to the secularism of the constitution. And we have a member of parliament saying a communal statement like what he has said, I think is deplorable and is unacceptable. And Mr. Owaisi is a well-read man. I have met him, I've spoken to him. It does not befit him
absolutely
to make such a statement. And I think, Mr. Owaisi, as a citizen of this country, not as a Hindu or a Muslim, as a citizen of this country, I request you and I urge you to protect the Constitution, to stand for every citizen, because that is your duty. Your duty is not to tell what a child is. A child born on Indian soil is an Indian citizen first, irrespective of the religion. And today you've insulted all Indians by making
such
a statement. I did not expect it from you. I'm very sorry to hear it. Please apologize to the nation and don't repeat it again.
My question to the viewers is, should Asaduddin Owaisi apologize? And if Asaduddin Owaisi does not believe in the Indian constitution, then should Asaduddin Owaisi stop being a member of parliament in the Lok Sabha? Because a person who disrespects the constitution has no right to be a member of parliament. It appears to me, Sudhanshu Trivedi, that Asaduddin Owaisi's intellectual idol is Praveen Togadia. Asaduddin Owaisi's intellectual idol is Mohan Bhagwat. Asaduddin Owaisi's intellectual idol is Champat Rai, National General Secretary of the VHP, because Asaduddin Owaisi is trying to appear to be, he wants to be for the Islamic community what Praveen Togadia wants to be for the Hindu community. Neither will Praveen Togadia succeed, nor will Asaduddin Owaisi succeed.
Even the Islamic community does not approve of his statement.
I'm sure the Islamic community will not approve of his statement. He's trying to be a hero here. Asaduddin Owaisi is trying to be a hero here tonight. Now, if Asaduddin Owaisi should apologize, you can tweet using that hashtag and you can tag Asaduddin Owaisi onto it. Asaduddin Owaisi, hear the voice of people. Whether you're a Hindu or a Muslim, a Parsi or a Jew, tell us, should Asaduddin Owaisi stop playing this kind of divisive politics? We'd like to hear from you. Sudhanshu Trivedi is now taking you on. Sudhanshu Trivedi to Mr. Owaisi.
Actually, what Asaduddin Owaisi has said, it is having two dimensions. One is religious dimension. He has expressed some specific belief of Islam. I think this is the purview of the Islamic clerics and the religious leader of the Islam whether to approve it or to denounce it. Second dimension is the political dimension. Since he is a political leader, so whatever he has spoken, definitely it should have some political angle. The political angle, what he is saying, is explicit and it is historically proven that there are certain parties which have played a very sharp communal politics among the Muslim community. From north to south, each and every state where there are 10 to 15% Muslim, first polarize them, get hold of the vote, and then some other parties will come in the name of so-called secularism. This is the same thing which Congress has done in 70s and 60s. This is the same thing which Mulayam Singh has done in UP. This is the same formula which Lalu Yadav done in Bihar. This is the same formula which Badruddin Ajmal done in Assam. This is the same thing which Mamta is doing in Bengal. This is the same thing which Muslim League is doing in Kerala.
And what is Yogi Adityanath doing? And what is Praveen Togadia doing? And what is Mohan Bhagwat doing?
Politics of sharp polarization.
And today you are preaching, Mr. Oasi. I take strong objection to that. Why don't you condemn Mr. Yogi Adityanath? Why don't you say that Ghar Vapsi does not exist? This is all bullshit.
Gaurav Bhatia, your party was one of the stamp proponents of these type of rubbish ideas. Do you remember when Mulayam Singh Yadav was the first time Chief Minister of UP? On 10th October 1919, a rally in Lucknow, he had said that the Muslims can have even the illegal weapons.
Where is love jihad? You tell me, except the BJP headquarters.
When you were speaking, I was not disturbing. First, you complete your statement, then I will speak.
This term has been framed by the BJP leaders in the BJP headquarters, taking instruction from VSP and Bajrang Dal.
Very interesting, Sudhanshu Trivedi.
No,
very interesting, Mr. Trivedi, that you don't take on Asaduddin Owaisi, but you take on Gaurav Bhatia. Very interesting.
No.
Very, very interesting.
Gaurav Bhatia, he is a learned lawyer and he is saying those things which are totally illegal.
I am asking.
The love jihad phrase was used by
The debate today,
Mr. Achyutanand, who was the
Sudhanshu Trivedi. Sudhanshu Trivedi, the debate
the
is on Asaduddin Owaisi's comment.
Court has acknowledged this thing.
Why are you saying
that this is framed by BJP?
Why are you
this
being
is the consistent propaganda against the BJP and the Sangh Parivar.
Now, Arnav,
also I would like to say, you have tried to equate Mohan Bhagwat and Asaduddin Owaisi.
Yes,
this is highly objectionable.
Why not?
How you can say like this, if you want to say what the Hinduism is, go by the Supreme Court judgment of 1995. It is not at all in religion. Even if, by the words of Togaria, I am not here to support the statement of Mr. Togaria, but whatever Togaria has said, it is historically proven.
What? Mr. One minute. Here's what Togadia says. Gaurav Bhatia, 1 minute.
He is saying
tonight. No. This is an interesting turn on the debate. Sudhanshu Trivedi, one minute. Now, Mr. Owaisi, if I can have your attention, please. Mr. Owaisi, can I have your attention, please, on the debate? The BJP spokesperson says that whatever Praveen Togadia says is historically proven. What does Praveen Togadia say? Praveen Togadia says the ancestors of Indian Muslims were Hindus. Praveen Togadia says the ancestors of Indian Christians are also Hindus. Owaisi says every child is born a Muslim. So Owaisi is trying to do a Togadia. 1 minute. What does the VHP say? The VHP says Ghar Vapsi program is a reclamation project of Indian society. What does Owaisi say? Owaisi says embracing Islam will be the real homecoming. You are justifying Togadia and Owaisi is justifying himself. You seem to be made for each other, Sudhanshu Trivedi. In this kind of highly polarized politics, you and Owaisi seem to be made for each other.
In the beginning of Owaisi implies that as if India is a Muslim country. This politics started from 1916 when in Lucknow Congress session, Congress accepted the separate electorate for Muslims. And I would like to remember to your viewers, you know what was written in the electoral constituencies, the Mohammedan constituencies and the non-Mohammedan constituencies. The Congress accepted in 1916. The politics of this type of divisive communal mindset is continuing since last 100 years.
No. Why are you doing this? Asaduddin Owaisi.
Are we to be governed by the examples?
Gaurav Bhatia, a minute. Gaurav, you see, Asaduddin Owaisi is remaining completely silent on this debate tonight. There can only be two reasons
for his
silence.
Because he has nothing to say on this.
No, there are two reasons. One is that Asaduddin Owaisi has nothing to say. B is that Asaduddin Owaisi has achieved his purpose, which is just polarizing the situation as best as he can and try to emerge as some kind of a person here who takes the credit for polarizing the situation. I'd like to draw you in, Asaduddin Owaisi, and I'd like to ask you this. Why are you doing this? You know that you have done a U-turn. You know you are contradicting what you have said earlier. You know that what you are doing today is contradicted by what you've said in your past. I know what you've said in previous interviews. By ascribing superiority to one religion above all others, by claiming that all non-Muslims are converts, and by saying that Islam is the real home to all religions, Mr. Owaisi, you have proven your hypocrisy. I'm sorry to have to say this on television today, but you have proven your hypocrisy. You have in the past praised India's pluralism and praised India's diversity. And you have said that pluralism is India's soul. Are you so desperate? Are you so desperate today, Asaduddin Owaisi? Are you so desperate today to somehow get a few votes and emerge as a Muslim leader in India that you are willing to contradict what you've said in the past?
I can, Mr. Arnab Goswami, I have told you many times I can have a debate with you for at least 24 hours minimum. But you must allow me to answer your barrage of questions which
nobody is stopping you.
No, but if you stop, I can, because the anchor becomes a lecturer and a professor. So the anchor should give an opportunity to the guest he has called to reply back to all the allegations.
All the anchor is telling you, Mr. Owaisi, if you want me to put it bluntly to you, is
can you please stop sermonizing and allow me to rebut all your baseless allegations which you are making?
Sure, but
you allow me at least 1 minute, Your Honor?
Yes, no, surely I give you a minute, and if you want more than a minute, but after that you'll have to let me rebut you as well. Go ahead, Mr. Owaisi. Defend yourself the best you can.
Certainly, your Lordship.
Thank you for the sarcasm.
No, thank you. Please understand, Mr. Arnab Goswami, this is part of an Islamic faith. You have all the right to disagree. I will never work for Islamic domination or to make this country an Islamic Sharia compliant, which will never happen. The Constitution is supreme to me. Freedom of religion, freedom of expression. Now, if I am saying that by 2021, this country has to become a Muslim country, Mr. Arnab Goswami has all the right to put all those allegations which you have just made.
Okay.
If I say that Muslims are nationalists and others are not nationalists, it is rubbish. I have never said that. I have reiterated my faith. You have
counter
all the
question
right,
one.
Mr. Goswami and the country.
Counter question one.
Disagree with me.
Counter question one. No, counter question one. Why have you woken up to this claim now, Mr. Owaisi? Mr. Owaisi, everybody watching the news knows. Mr. Owaisi, I didn't stop you before a minute. You spoke for more than a minute.
And I'm really sad that the Samajwadi Party spokesperson is sermonizing about a particular religion. He should be ashamed of himself that within his party, talks about the Yadava domination, which are only 9% in Uttar Pradesh, but all the five MPs, from his president to daughter-in-law to sons and niece and nephew, are from one particular caste.
Sudhanshu Trivedi. One second. By the way, may I make another observation here? One second. Mr. Owaisi, my observation, Mr. Asaduddin Owaisi, is that you are very willing to engage in a political debate on this program with the Samajwadi Party. But for some strange and obscure reason, which I'm sure every viewer of NewsHour is noticing, you don't want to fight with the BJP. Now, you know, Mr. Owaisi, many people are saying that you are the BJP's creation. Let me complete.
That I have sent a notice to Mr. Lalu Prasad Yadav for certain allegations.
You can send as many notices as you want.
Newspaper, and when very soon Mr. Lalu Prasad Yadav will have to come and cool his heels in the court of Hyderabad.
My question is, Mr. Owaisi.
You have a selective thinking.
Mr. Owaisi.
I have said that there's a huge difference between me
Mr. Asaduddin Owaisi, will you?
That the Hindus are only nationalists.
Mr. Owaisi,
I am not saying that the RSS, which says that talks about Hindus.
Now you are beginning to backtrack.
Hindus are nationalists. I am not saying.
Now you are beginning to backtrack.
I am saying this is part of my faith. You disagree.
Mr. Owaisi,
I am not connected.
Mr. Owaisi, India's
nationalism to a religion, to a particular.
Oh, Mr. Owaisi, why don't you have some consistency for God's sake? Why don't you for once remember what you used to say earlier? Oh, Mr. Owaisi, Three questions. It's not a question of faith. It's a question of allegiance to the Constitution. Mr. Owaisi, can you tell me one occasion in the past, Mr. Owaisi, freedom of expression
and under freedom of religion.
Mr. Owaisi, come.
You can consult
any great legal lawyer or alumni. Ask him.
What is wrong in that?
A person like you, who does not even remember what he has said in the past, has no business asking me, giving me lectures in the law. I am asking you, why have you suddenly woken up to this claim? You have never claimed before that every child born in India is a Muslim, and that the parents of every child and the society converts him to other religions. Show me when you said that earlier. Answer my question.
This is a faith of mine.
And your faith came last month?
I am saying that a Hindu religion is connected to India's nationalism or Islam religion is connected.
Mr. Owaisi, if it is your faith, you have no right to transgress on the faith of others.
I disagree. Please disagree.
Mr. Owaisi, you have no right to transgress on the faith of others, and I get Sudhanshu Trivedi into the debate because you will remember, Mr.
No, I have not. I have not transgressed.
Of course you have.
I have not transgressed.
Of course you have. Did
Article
you not say?
Article 25 is ample protection for what I am saying.
Mr. Owaisi, you know your only politics today.
Article 25.
Your only politics today, and you're forcing me to say this to you. I think I'm going to have to say this fairly bluntly to you now.
I'm a politician, Mr. Arnab Goswami. I'm not an anchor of Times Now. You have called me and I have to answer to all the baseless allegations which you are making.
First of all, Mr. Owaisi, and I'll let Sudhanshu Trivedi respond. I know you are a politician and I know I'm a journalist. And that is what makes you biased and prejudiced.
Good.
And that is what makes me objective.
At least let it get
so,
it right.
So you, I will respond to your prejudice.
You are.
I will respond to your prejudice, your bias and your political ambitions, which are growing by the minute, even at the cost of polarizing Indian society with straight questions, because it is time. Because it is time, Mr. Owaisi.
I am not into the CRP ratings that
Mr. Owaisi.
Or you is number two. I don't put all those things. I don't say 52 weeks number one.
Mr. Owaisi.
I am saying the truth. Mr. Owaisi, isn't that their freedom of expression? I have all the right to say this is my faith. Article 19.
Hold yourself back.
Is clear cut.
Counter him.
Hold yourself back, and I'd like Sudhanshu Trivedi to come into the debate. One second. Sudhanshu Trivedi, please. Sudhanshu Trivedi.
Now, you look why Asaduddin Owaisi and Samajwadi Party is having some sort of tussle. The reason being, Samajwadi Party is the inspiration of Owaisi. What Mulayam Singh Yadav has said in the previous years, that SIMI is a cultural organization. In 1990, he said even Muslims can have illegal weapons.
This is let him speak.
Which has managed, and ultimately now they are ruling the state of Uttar Pradesh. So this is the inspiration of Owaisi to expand MIM in the northern India. Now, I would also like to correct the statement. He has not said all Indians are born Muslims. He has said everybody born in this world is a Muslim. It means all Christians, Jews, Persians, Zoroastrians, Buddhists, Sikhs, Jain, Confucians, Tao, Shinto, all. It means if you go by the spirit of the statement of Mr. Owaisi, I don't think any difference in the spirit of what Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi is saying.
Aircraft came from
and the third thing, he has said it is his right to propagate his religion.
Aren't you
I would like to remind him the Supreme Court judgment in 1977. It has made it categorically clear that right to propagate your religion doesn't mean the right to convert somebody to your religion.
There was a helmet also. Isn't that part of your faith?